Are you in high school? Then this podcast is not for you. This is for parents, grandparents, and just anyone else that is interested in what a high schooler does on a day-to-day basis. Brought to you by me, Parker Conti, Devin Kahn, and Chelsea Rodas. We interviewed introvert Connor Beinstein and extrovert Allison about their lives as high schoolers, with a twist. We specifically chose to interview an introvert and extrovert because our goal was to compare their lives. Here's how the day went. Our first interviewee, Allison, is a self-titled extrovert who spends most of her time with her friends and family, that is, if she isn't doing homework.
How does my morning usually go? Well, I usually wake up at around 6:35. If I want to give myself a few more minutes, only till 6:45, and then I would actually get up. I would do my normal, usual morning routine, and then after, I go down to my bus stop at around 7:50 a.m., The bus usually comes at almost 8, so I get on the bus. It's usually a 10 to 15 minute ride, and it all varies on what time I usually get to school. It can either be like at 8:10, 8:15 a.m., or 8:20, sometimes even later, but it all depends. And then I just, if I do come on time, I usually just go to my friend's table and I talk with everyone in the meantime till the bell rings to go to class. But if I come late, I just go straight to class. So first, what I usually do when I get to school is go to my table, like my friend's table, my table, and I will just talk to everyone and like update them, and they update me. If not, I'll go somewhere else or like take a walk. For my favorite classes, I would say my favorite classes from last semester would be psychology. I like biology a lot. I have that now. Math, I like. And for my not so favorite classes would be history. And mainly just history. English too are not my favorites because like I don't really like the topics as much. I'm not really as interested as in like the other subjects like psych, math, and science. So yeah, I usually like to talk to other people in my classes, or do I like to keep myself like situated alone? I would say that I prefer, it all depends actually. If I have friends in the class, then I would most likely talk to them, but if I don't, then I would mainly be alone. But if it's like a very hard level class, like I'm in a few of those, I would prefer to be alone and like not talk to anyone so I can focus. So where do I usually sit at lunch is another question, and with who? I usually sit, since I'm a junior, I sit in the junior section, and I sit with my friends mainly. The other question is, do you participate in class often? Why or why not? Well, I do and I don't. It all depends on the class and what we're learning, because I only participate when I know the answer, which is not, like, it is actually pretty often, but it all depends on the material, because in some cases I don't really participate as much just because I don't like speaking in front of people publicly. And for the last question is, do you prefer to work alone or in groups? That all depends also. If I'm capable of doing it by myself, like I'll be capable to do anything by myself, but it all depends, because like if the teacher assigns it to be in groups, I'll work in a group. Obviously, if it's alone, I'll do it alone. But if I had the option, I would do both, but it all depends on the subject material, like I said. So overall, being a junior is really hard. The amount of work and all of the, like, the worries you have to, like, deal with, like, testing, like, SAT testing, colleges, all of that. Like, for me, just the amount of work and just thinking about all of this and, like, everyone just pressuring you most of the time is very stressful for me in my daily school life, but I don't let it affect me. at all because I want to live life at its fullest, and I try my best no matter what to get everything the way it's supposed to be, which is right. And I just try really hard, even with the most stressful situations. I like to try really, really hard. For the following question, what do I do during OB learning centers and if I have those? For OB, I work productively by doing my homework. I do finish most of it most of the time, but it all depends if I'm really focused on it. Or other times during OB, I would just like relax a bit, go on my phone because of such a long, stressful day. And for learning centers, I can't really say anything about that because I don't have any learning centers at all. Like, I've never had one either. So, yes. For the following question, if I participate in any after-school activities, to answer that question, no, I do not as of now. What I do is I go on the bus, go home, and I mainly just babysit my brothers, and I also do my homework at home because I just feel more comfortable here and I mainly have to come home after school. But that's just as of now. That could change because I am thinking of joining certain things. For the following question, how long does it take me to do my homework? It all depends on how long it takes me because it depends on the amount of work I have that the teacher has sent. For the most part, I usually take a couple hours actually. Like, I go to sleep late because of that. But there are some days that I barely get any homework, so I finish like at around 5-6. But that's not always because most of the time I finish at about 11 or so. Okay? What I would say is just continue, live your life at its fullest. Don't stress out that much. What I usually do is just follow my daily routine that I usually do. Just go to class, focus, take notes, do homework, that's it. I usually go to sleep at 11 p.m. I would just like to say that me being a junior, stress is not the way to go. Like, don't stress out about anything because it will actually bring you nowhere. I'm a very anxious person myself, and literally I've already experienced a lot that being stressed and anxious will literally make things worse, which is very true. So I would say take your time with everything, do everything with your best ability, don't listen to others, be yourself. And just don't let anything get to you because that won't help you at all, and just live life at its fullest.
At first, we expected to see a very big difference in the way they live their lives, but the more we spoke with them, the more we realized they had a lot in common. An example of this would be how they spend their time after school, where they both go home and claim to just do their homework. While there's a lot to compare in our findings, we found something fairly interesting when we were looking for our interviewees. We had a lot of trouble when it came to finding an introvert. In fact, the only introvert we ever found was the one we interviewed, and they chose to remain anonymous. We also found that this introvert spoke a lot less and communicated more through actions such as hand gestures. Meanwhile, Allison spoke in a lot more detail.